How you doing, Curious? In recent months, Meghan Markle and Prince Harry have constantly been giving interviews and appearing on all kinds of different programs. It seems that Meghan just can't stop talking, but being an actress, she's most certainly used to the interviews and all, and she often speaks out about all that she has suffered last year when she was apparently the most talked about person on social media. Wait, what? And yes, Curious, this is just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to the Sussexes and these platforms. What does the former Duchess think about social networks? Oh, and it seems that the actress has changed a lot, especially if we consider that there is a biographer who says that she wanted to be the most famous person in the world, and marrying a prince did surely help her achieve that goal. And all is very nice with Meghan, but what about Harry? How does he feel about all of these changes in his life? So you can't miss this video full of news from the former Duke and Duchess of Sussex and their new life. Oh, and of course, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on the notifications so you can get notified when our newest videos get released. First of all, let's start with what was said by this well-known biographer, Lady Colin Campbell, who has also previously written about none other than Harry's mother, Princess Diana. In her BBC radio show, she said that Meghan had left behind one of her biggest dreams when she joined the royal family. And what dream was she talking about? I'll let you know in just a moment. Oh, and not to mention that Harry, like the rest of his family, had led her to attract less attention from people and even had forbidden her to wear many things, including wearing whatever she wanted. You know, the royal dress codes. Oh, how cruel that must have been. But seriously, the biographer went on, and now with a little bit more force. She accused her of getting mixed up in business affairs and politics in general, which is something a member of the royal family should never do. They have to remain neutral. But wait, Curious, this is just the beginning. What she said next will probably leave you just as surprised as it left me. And according to what Colin said, Meghan is instructing her public relations people, you know, PR, to make her the most famous person on earth. Though, wouldn't being married to a prince already make her that anyways? Why would the biographer lady be so angry? I mean, what do you think? Does she have any evidence? The royal biographer also added that to become so famous, in let's call it a Kardashian style, you have to generate a lot of controversy. Can you imagine Meghan doing things like Kim or Kylie had done? But most of all, do you think that leaving the British royalty forever might have been something to do with the plan? Well, that's what this person seems to be suggesting. Miss Campbell also admitted that she had even contributed to Meghan's plan, but unwittingly, as she wrote a book called Meghan and Harry, The Real Story, one that she launched shortly after Omid Scobie and Carolyn Duran released their own book, Finding Freedom, in which seemed to show the former Dukes in a much more positive way. And speaking of the said book, we have a video about what was revealed in it, and you can check it out by clicking on the link above. The renowned biographer also added that she was very offended when the couple, through some mutual friends, tried to sell a story about Meghan and her father. She said that she didn't care if Meghan became the most famous person on earth in the world or not, but she wanted the story to be interesting and would not be persuaded to do it, let alone by a third party. Could it be that this nice lady is right about everything? That Markle is following a plan to become even more famous? On the other hand, do you remember when I told you that the former Duke and Duchess have been appearing in all sorts of media? Well, it's just that Meghan came out to talk about the risks her public figure has taken by leaving British royalty. During the interview for Fortune magazine, the former Duchess of Sussex revealed that all the steps she took from leaving the most famous royal family and talking on any job that she could in the professional world do, she did for her and Harry's son, little Prince Archie. Her exact words were, "Everything I do is for Archie, our son. Perhaps from the outside it seems risky, but if you live an authentic life, I don't even know if you could define it as a risk. You simply do what is right." Had you been in her position, would you have done the same thing, Curious? Oh, and do you remember I was going to tell you what the actress thinks about social media? Well, it turns out that in the same interview with Fortune magazine, Meghan had said that in 2018, when she had married Prince Harry, she had gotten rid of her Instagram account and that she will most likely never have one again. Moreover, in the same interview, she explained that she did it to preserve her mental health and that she has not been on social networks for a long time. She also said that there is an account for her and Prince Harry, but that it is managed by a whole team. The said team wouldn't be the public relations team that the biographer wasn't talking about, would it be? Anyways, on the other hand, Meghan added that she does not know what is being said on social media nowadays and that it helps her. She also acknowledged that she cares a lot about people who have become obsessed with social media because despite the fact that it's become a big part of our culture in recent years, it is still an addiction like any other. Oh, and well, I guess I'll have to tone down the amount of time I spend on Twitter and Instagram. Markle also got more serious and said there is something that is algorithmically generating an obsession and that it's very unhealthy. There's a documentary on Netflix, which is exactly what the former Duchess is talking about, and it's called The Social Dilemma. Could it be that Meghan is advertising it, one way or another? Ha, I'm just kidding, Curious. Most likely, both Meghan and Harry began to take action because after the actress joined the royal family, she began to experience a lot of online bullying. And in an interview for a podcast called Teenager Therapy, the former Duchess said, "I'm told that in 2019, I was the most trolled person in the entire world, male or female. Now, 8 months of that, I wasn't even visible. I was on maternity leave with a baby. But what was able to be manufactured and churned out, it's almost unsurvivable. That's so big that you can't even think what that feels like. And we understand Meghan, it must have been hard." She added that bullying is so intense that one cannot imagine what it feels like, and that it does not matter if you are 15 or 25 years old. If people say things about you that are not true, what that does to your mental and emotional health is very harmful, and it's not the first time that both Meghan and Harry have talked about mental health issues. Markle said that we all know what it's like to be hurt, to have our feelings hurt, and to be so isolated and indifferent. The intention of the former Dukes is primarily to generate a more empathetic outlook in people, and that will help them come together as a community. Because for them, despite being connected in the media, we are disconnected as a community. On the other hand, Harry, who just like his brother William, has been involved in mental health issues quite a lot lately, has said that he mediates daily and that he never thought that he was the right person for that kind of activity. In that same interview, he added that being vulnerable in today's world and society takes a lot of strength and courage. Harry often talked about how the media affected his mother and the immense pressure that she was under. In an interview with The Telegraph, the prince talked about how it was his duty to protect his family as he doesn't want a repeat of the past. But what about when the prince meets up with his family? Do they have anything planned? Well, apparently, according to the British tabloid The Sun, Harry will be visiting the royal fam in a few weeks. He has important business to discuss with his grandmother, Queen Elizabeth. This time, he will not be able to count on the company of Meghan, who does not seem to show interest in returning to the United Kingdom, even for a vacation. The issues Harry and Grandma Liz will be discussing are the involvement of her grandson and his wife in the American political affairs. I don't think the Queen is happy that Harry is taking interest in the American political issues and not the ones in his home country of the United Kingdom. In any case, Meghan and Harry's intention was to call on Americans to reject hate speech, misinformation on social media, and the negativity that it all generates. But it seems that Donald Trump saw all of those messages as support for his political opponent, Joe Biden. Because usually the British royalty normally doesn't vote, of course, and they don't talk about political matters either, since they have to maintain a neutral stance in these matters. So Grandma Elizabeth is not completely happy with the new attitude of her grandson, and it seems that Harry feels more free than ever to say anything that comes into his mind. So Curious, what are your thoughts about the whole situation and what the famous biographer has claimed about the former Duke and Duchess of Sussex? Did you imagine such a big change in Harry? Do you think that they can put aside their differences at the table at least and share some lunch? And what about Meghan? Did you know that she has suffered so much due to bullying on social media? Let me know in the comments below, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. And we will see you again tomorrow with a new video.